watching evergreen bend in the snow. Remembering Christmas the way that been so many seasons ago, where the children would reach for their stockings and open a present they found. The light from the tree would shine bright in their eyes, reflecting the love all around. But now this year there's no one to hold this, no reason for trimming the tree. And just as a tear made its way to the floor, she heard voices outside start to sing. Merry Christmas to all who made merry. Merry Christmas to be on just one. May the joy of the season surround you. The carolers sang as she opened the doors, and faces of friends in the crowd, and all of the shadows of lonely reminders were driven away by the sound. Oh, but now the heart that for years had been silent was suddenly
Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. And as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found a child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man, not willing to make her a public example, but minded to put her away privately. While he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying,
Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost, and she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins.
Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son. They shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted, is God with us. And Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife, and knew her not, for she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus. And the child grew and waxed strong in spirit, filled with wisdom, and the grace of God was upon him.
Son, why have you worried us so? Your father and I have been looking for you.
You should have known I'd been about my father's business.
And Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit into Galilee. And there went out fame of him throughout all the region round about.
Repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Make his path straight. O generations of vipers, who hath warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Refer therefore priests and meet for repentance, and think not to say within yourself, we have Abraham to our father. For I say unto you that God is able of these stones to raise up our children unto Abraham. And now also the axe is laid unto the roots of the tree. Therefore every tree which bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. And he baptize you with water unto repentance. But he that comes after me is mightier than I, whose shoes I am not worthy to bear. He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire, whose fan is in his hand, and you will thoroughly purge his glory. And gather wheat into the garden, but he will burn up the chaff with unquenchable fire.
Then cometh Jesus from Galilee to Jordan unto John to be baptized of him.
I have need to be baptized of thee, and comest thou to me?
Suffer it to be so now, for thus it becometh us to fulfill all righteousness.
And Jesus, when he was baptized, went up straightway out of the water, and lo, the heavens were opened unto him, he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lighting upon him. And lo, a voice from heaven saying, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased."
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He hath sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of our Lord.
And when he was departed thence, he went into their synagogue, and behold, there was a man which had his hand withered.
Is it lawful to heal on the Sabbath day?
What man shall there be among you that shall have one sheep, and if it fall into a pit on the Sabbath day, will not lay hold on it and lift it out? How much then is a man better than a sheep? Wherefore it is lawful to do well on the Sabbath days. Stretch forth thine hand.
Now when he came nigh to the gate of the city, behold, there was a dead man carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. And much people of the city was with her. And when the Lord saw her, he had compassion on her.
Weep not. Young man, I say unto thee, arise.
These lay a great multitude of impotent folk, blind, halt, withered, waiting for the moving of the water. For an angel went down at a certain season into the pool, and troubled the water. And whosoever then first, after the troubling of the water, stepped in, was made whole, whatsoever disease he had. Now a certain man was there, which had an infirmity 38 years. When Jesus saw him lie, and knew that he had been now a long time in that case, he saith unto him,
"Wilt thou be made whole?"
"Sir, I have no man when the water is troubled to put me into the pool."
Rise, take up thy bed and walk. Behold, thou art made whole. Sin no more, lest a worse thing come unto thee.
He was teaching in one of the synagogues on the Sabbath. Behold, there was a woman which had a spirit of infirmity 18 years, and was bowed together, and could in no wise lift up herself. And when Jesus saw her, he called her to him, and said unto her,
Woman, thou art loosed from thy infirmity.
Sitting by the wayside, they heard that Jesus passed by and cried out.
Jesus, Jesus, oh Jesus, Jesus, thou Son of David, have mercy upon me. Jesus, oh Jesus, over here, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, please, Jesus, over here. Please help me, Jesus.
Go home. Bring it up. What will ye that I should do unto you?
Oh, Lord, that my eyes may be opened.
Death for the glory of God, that the Son of God might be glorified thereby. Let us go into Judea again.
Master, the Jews of late have sought to stone thee, and thou goest thither again?
Are there not 12 hours in a day? If any man walk in the day, he stumbleth not, because he seeth the light of this world. But if any man walketh in night, he stumbleth, because there is no light in him. Our friend Lazarus sleepeth, but I go that I may awake him out of this sleep.
Lord, if he sleep, he shall do well.
Lazarus is dead. And I am glad for your sakes that I was not there, to the intent you may believe. Nevertheless, let us go unto him.
Let us also go that we may die with him.
Lord, if thou hadst been here, my brother had not died. But I know that even now, whatsoever I will ask of God, God will give it to thee.
Thy brother shall rise again.
I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection of the last day.
I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this?
Son of God, which shall come into the world.
He shall never die. The master has come and called for thee.
Oh Lord, if thou hadst been here, my brother had not died.
Where had you laid him?
Lord, come and see.
Wait a minute, too. Where else are you going to lay?
What's this tomb for? Behold how he loved him.
Take ye away the stone.
Oh.
Lord, by this time he stinketh, for he hath been dead for 4 days.
Said I not unto thee, that if thou wouldst believe, thou shouldst see the glory of God? Father, I thank thee that thou hast heard me, not know that thou hearest me always, but because of the people which stand by, I said it, that they may believe that thou hast sent me. Lazarus, come forth. Lazarus, come forth.
Come forth, Lazarus.
My daughter is even now dead. But come and lay thy hand upon her, and she shall live.
Who touched me?
Master, the multitude thronged thee and pressed thee and says, now who touched me?
Somebody hath touched me, for I perceive that the virtue's gone out of me.
The virtue's gone out of me. What is this man talking about?
Jesus, for 12 long years I've had this issue of blood. I've had to sell everything I own, even my home, to pay doctors who could not help me. But with just one touch of your garment, I'm whole. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Jairus, thy daughter is dead. Please trouble not the minister.
Fear not. Believe only, and she shall be made whole.
Come on.
Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done. Why sleep ye? Rise and pray, lest ye enter into temptation. Whom seek ye?
Jesus of Nazareth.
I am he. Whom seek ye?
Jesus of Nazareth.
I have told you that I am he. If therefore ye seek me, let these go their way. The cup which my father hath given me, shall I not drink it? Suffer ye this far. Be ye come out as against a thief with swords and staffs. When I was daily with you in the temple, ye stretched forth no hands against me. But this is your hour, and the power of darkness.
Will you come with us?
Come on. Don't you go with us. What has he done?
Jesus, my son, I love you so. Even before your birth, when the angel appeared unto me and told me of your coming and of your special purpose, you have been my joy and my hope. When Joseph and I took you to the temple at 8 days old to fulfill our laws of custom, the devout man called Simeon held you, proclaimed unto God that he could die in peace because he had seen God's salvation. And then he blessed us, and he told me that a sword would pierce my soul. And Anna, the prophetess who served God in the temple, said that those who seek redemption in Jerusalem should look to you. So much had happened, I didn't understand. But I kept all of these things in my heart and pondered upon them. I remember when you were but 12 years of age and we had left Jerusalem after the Feast of Passover. You had tarried behind. When we could not find you among our kinsmen, we returned to Jerusalem to seek you. And 3 days later, we found you in the temple in the midst of the doctors. Everyone was astounded at your understanding and answers. And Joseph and I were so surprised and so relieved to find you. I scolded you, and you looked at me and told me I should have known that you would be about your father's business. And again, I did not understand. You were such a good child, Jesus. You grew in wisdom and in stature, and you became a man under the grace of God. I have followed you, and I have witnessed some of your great works. You have healed their sick. You've made their lame to walk again. You've opened blinded eyes. You have even raised the dead. And this, they do this to you? I don't understand. You have done no wrong, Jesus. Above all men, you have done no wrong. Now, Jesus, this one thing I do understand. I now know why Simeon said that a sword would pierce my soul.
Woman, behold thy son. Behold thy mother. God, oh God. Father, oh God, I thirst. God, oh God, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Oh God, Father, Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit. It is finished.
Thank you. Halfway gone.
Yeah. There's still a dash left. Mm-hmm. My lady was inside. We can still go. Still go for a while.
Thank you.
Gates and doors above and windows fastened now. I spent the night in sleeplessness and rose at every sound. Heaven called the sob, heaven feared the day. We'll find the soldiers breaking through to drag us away. Oh, and just before the sunrise, I heard something at the wall. The gates began to rattle and a voice began to call. I hurried to the window, I looked down into the street, expecting swords and torches and the sound of soldiers' feet. Oh, but there was no one there but Mary, so I went down to let her in. Rhoda John stood there beside me as she told me where she'd been. Well, she said they moved him in the night, and he none of us knows where. The stone's been rolled away, and now his body isn't there. So we both ran toward the garden, and John ran on ahead. We found the stone in an empty tomb, just the way they never said. But the winding sheet they wrapped him in was just and how the way they'd taken him was more than I could tell. Oh, now something strange had happened. What they were right did not know. Now John believed in the miracle, but I just turned to go. Circumstance and speculation could lift me very high. Oh, because I see them crucified, Lord, and then I watched him die. Oh, now back inside the house again, the guilt and anguish came. Oh, now everything I promised him just led him to my shame. But when at last it came to choices, I denied I knew his name. Oh, and even if he was alive, it wouldn't be the shadows from the room. Now Jesus stood before me with his arms held up and wide. And I got down on my knees and I clung to him. And oh, but he raised me to my feet. And as I looked through his eyes, oh, the love was shining out from him like sunlight from the sky. Oh, guilt in my confusion disappeared in sweet release. Oh, in every fear I ever had just melted in pain.
Suffered and died, amen, for you. He was our substitute. We were the one that should have died. Amen. That cross shouldn't have been his. It should have been ours. Amen. That he went to the cross for us and died for us. Amen. That we might have life and have it more abundantly. Come tonight, would you? Surely, 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 you that are lost tonight have been touched. Surely you've had an invitation of the Holy Ghost to come. Don't say no. Don't say no tonight. Come, would you? Come and give your heart to God. Amen. I know the enemy may be hopping up on your shoulder and telling you that you can't live it. Yes, you can. He'll come in and live within you and help you. Amen. I can't live it either. But he said when he was here in his earthly ministry, he said, if any man believeth on me, he said, my Father will love him and we'll come in and make our abode with him. Amen. He'll come in and live within you and help you and walk with you. Amen. Hallelujah. And help you in every situation. Come tonight, would you? Surely you'll come. Surely you that are lost will come tonight. After you've seen somewhat what our Lord and Savior went through to pay for your salvation. Amen. And my salvation. And the salvation of the whole wide world. Come tonight, would you? Please get up and come. You that are lost, come. Friend, come to yourself tonight, would you? You'll never be in a surrounding like this. God bless these young boys. God bless these young boys. If these young boys are touched, I'm sure that you are. Listen, friend, you're going to say no one time too often. Amen. What if you would go out to meet God tonight without coming up here and repenting of your sin? You'd think of this scene throughout eternity. You'd give 100 worlds if you owned them. Amen. To have
or he'll be hell. Come tonight.
get up and come. I believe if one will come,